time was all Europe cowered at Napoleon's feet, and only England then was guarding her from slavery and defeat. And the South style land of the free saw the chance to advance its own cause at the cost of Europe's liberty. I took the British side back in 1812 when the Yankees went to war on us, and so in doing went and did my duty as I saw it then, and joined the 104th New Brunswick Regiment. And I was at Lundy's Lane firing wildly in the dark, so many Yankees there I couldn't help but hit my mark. I witnessed hell on earth a mile from Niagara Falls in a hill of musket balls. Allow me to explain. I was at Lundy's Lane. That fool James Madison saw it was a matter of mere marching north to conquer us, or so it was he said. But 2 years more have passed and we have made him rue the day in 1812 he Kettle, so before his egg was laid. These godless Republicans are trying once again to liberate us quite against our will, so they decree. But they have only this to be proud of, they have made themselves a whore in bed with the tyrant of Paris. And I was at Lundy's Lane and off their bold attack. They do this every year, and every year we beat them back. Canadians and British fought as one against our common foe, and what I'll have you know was our most bitter fuck campaign. I was at Lundy's Lane. In the night, lit only by the flash of musket fire in confusion, so by thick smoke and the screaming of the maimed, I battled hand to hand for hours, a scrounge among the dead, to replace my powder flint and shot before the next rush came. In the churchyard amid the graves we met each fresh assault, and at length we gained the upper hand and forced the foe to yield. And as morning drew on, we staggered up a bloody hill and watched in sheer exhaustion as the Yankees quit the field. And I was at Lundy's Lane, where about a proudly shone, where one in three that took the field was dead before the dawn. And only just 5 words, as simple as to be absurd, I could sum up the horror of all war and death and pain. I was at Lundy's Lane.